The overhead press is by far the best all-around exercise for building massive shoulders. Not only that, but it does a great deal for building the upper chest, putting mass on the triceps, and increasing your bench press strength. The overhead press, like most of the main lifts, doesn't just stimulate the obvious muscle groups, for example, the shoulders, upper chest, and triceps, however. It also helps strengthen the lats through heavy eccentric loading, engages the legs by using them as stabilizers, and of course, increases core strength. This movement, although not the most complicated, is a bit more complex than the bench press. Not just because it's easily butchered, but because your body is in an overall more vulnerable position since you have no support. A few things you want to avoid when shoulder pressing are pressing the bar in front of your body, not maintaining a tight core and arching your back too much, not locking out the lift, this is very common in the overhead press, and too wide of a grip, which leads to flared elbows. Like the bench press and any other big compound exercise, you don't want to start slapping weight on the bar until you've perfected the lift. Trying to lift too much weight on the overhead press is a surefire way to snap some shit up. Poor form on this lift can lead to anything from shoulder damage to straining your lower back or even neck pain. Perform the overhead press with solid form, however, and you'll strengthen your shoulders, lower back, and core. Not to mention, you'll build massive deltoids, a bigger upper chest, and thicker arms too. Keep in mind, if you're not strong enough to handle an empty bar with proper form for the prescribed volume, then starting out with the seated version of this exercise would be best. If that's not feasible, a standing or seated dumbbell shoulder press would be your next best option. How to overhead press. The setup. The rack should be set where the bar is at the same height as your collarbone. From there, you'll grip the bar with palms slightly wider than shoulder width apart. Wrap the thumbs around the bar and over the fingers and position the bar in the heel of the palm. If you're experiencing wrist pain from overhead pressing, you're likely gripping the bar in your fingers, putting unnecessary strain on the wrist. If the bar is directly over the wrist and the wrist directly over the elbow, you're in good shape. But if the bar and the wrist are not in line, you're likely not going to maximize pushing force and perhaps even experience wrist pain. From there, you'll pull yourself toward the bar so that it's resting on your collarbone, get in there nice and close. Make sure your forearms are vertical so your elbows are pointing down. Now we're standing nice and tall with our knees and hips locked, feet shoulder width apart, and chest up. Shoulders back and down, core tight, barbell at the clavicle, forearms vertical, elbows down. Now you're ready to press. First, raise your chest to the ceiling by arching your back a bit. Fix your eyes on something directly in front of you to ensure you're looking forward and not up. Now tilt your head back slightly to allow the bar to pass your nose and chin as you press the bar up in a straight line. Once the bar passes your forehead, shift your torso forward a bit and squeeze your glutes. At this point, the bar should be in direct alignment with your shoulders and the front of your hips, and your head should be inside to where your ears are visible in front of your arms. Raise the bar until your elbows are locked, your shoulders and traps should get a nice squeeze at the top. When you're bringing the bar down, take a deep breath, tighten your core and glutes, and raise your chest up by arching your upper back slightly to ensure your head is out of the bar's way. Bring the barbell down to the collarbone in a straight line and repeat. To summarize, grip the bar slightly outside of shoulder width with the bar resting on your clavicle. Stand nice and tall with your hips and knees locked and feet shoulder width apart. Shoulders should be back and down and the core should remain tight. Tilt your head back slightly to avoid knocking yourself out and press the bar up in a straight line. Tuck your head in, lock your arms, and squeeze the shoulders and traps. If you're a bit overwhelmed by the instructions, don't be. In the beginning, you may notice yourself focusing quite a bit on a few of the cues mentioned, but with a little practice, the movement begins to feel much more natural. Did you find this video helpful? If so, click the like button below as it'll truly help out the channel. Is there a different exercise you want to master? Let me know what it is in the comments section below and I'll try to make a video on it. And if you haven't already, make sure you subscribe to the channel and turn on post notifications so you never miss another video. I hope that was helpful, and I'll talk to you in the next one. Peace.